Yo, what up 2K fans, this is your boy Venice. Today we're back for a new 2K22 video. Season 3 is live, ladies and gentlemen. Look at these beautiful Wildcats courts. I'm absolutely loving these courts. I hated the Season 2 Wildcats courts. But now we got some nice courts to record gameplay on. Even though today's video's gameplay is gonna be at the one-on-one, because who says season 3 says new moves added to the game? So we're gonna take a look at one move in particular. I'm probably gonna go over more of these in the next couple of days, but I wanted to test the Nikola Jokic fadeaway first. So if you want to equip it, you just go in the animation store into post fade and you'll see that Nikola Jokic moves. This one is highlighted with the season 3 release banner, so you can take a look at all the animations in this package. As you can see, it is hella quick. It is the fastest fadeaway in the game right now. I'm gonna cover all the things that you will need to know if you want to equip this fade and actually have success with it. So there you go, now you know how to actually equip this Nikola Jokic fade. So we're gonna get into some gameplay. I've got two one-on-one games to show you guys. We're gonna rock the shirtless Nuggets, that kind of training gear, pay a little tribute to our boy Nikola Jokic, the last year's MVP, NBA MVP. So let's rock this Nuggets gear for these games, and I'll see you guys when we get into gameplay to talk about this new move that 2K released. Alright, so game number one. I've got two gameplays to show you in this one-on-one court. So obviously I'm not going to go up against the best competition out there, but it doesn't matter at all. I'm just trying to showcase this move to you guys, this Nikola Jokic fadeaway. We're gonna check what kind of combinations we can do with this move, and also some pieces of advice on to how to utilize it. Now, the first thing that you're gonna realize when you try on this move, it is that it is so freaking fast that it is almost too fast, because a fadeaway animation, honestly, it's not like a standing jump shot. You can afford a fadeaway that it is a little bit slower, and it pretty much makes it very, very hard to actually green this fadeaway. Now, obviously, after a couple shots, couple faders, I got the hang of the timing. But obviously, I'm used to fading away on 2K. That is one of my go-to moves. So maybe if the fadeaway is not your bread and butter, you might want to try to pick another fadeaway than this one to start off with. Because I'm telling you guys, it is very, very hard to green, especially without a meter, which I still do recommend turning off though. So it is crazy fast. Now in my book, that is a huge perk, because I love getting my faders up the quickest possible. But it is, you know, it doesn't create a ton of space. Actually, it doesn't create a lot at all. He literally stands on one leg and basically shoots it right away. Now I'm just trolling this dude right there, first play of the game, because I lost my dribble. But yeah, like I said, it doesn't create much space at all, but it is extremely fast. So what I would advise is that if you're an experienced player with this type of playstyle, this mid-range crafty shot creating playstyle, try it on, equip it, and try to throw some faders into your, you know, your usual moves. Just try and switch faders. You'll see that with this one, you can pretty much surprise your opponent every single time you do it, because it is so fast and it's unpredictable. So it really helps into your kind of arsenal back to the basket game, because like I said, it is fast, it is unpredictable, and you can pretty much pull it off at every time you get an inch of space. So it is nice in that sense, but like I said earlier, if you have not mastered the normal fadeaways, so the other ones that are in the games, you might want to stay away of this one. Now look at this volleyball spike, bro. I don't know how the hell I got this block with these T-Rex arms, but we will take it. I was not about to lose this game. I think this dude had like a 25 win rate, so I was pretty locked in at the end of the game. We're gonna hit him with the nice turnaround. These turnarounds are clean though, I can't lie, they look pretty good with the leg in the air, like Dirk would do it so well. Now I challenge myself a little bit, lose my dribble intentionally and hit this guy with the pivot foot fadeaway. So this is going to wrap up this video. If you're not subbed already, make sure you subscribe, like the video if you enjoyed it, and I'll catch you guys in the next one. Peace. Yep.